Hello and welcome to Python Code Challenge 5 for beginners. To complete this challenge, develop some code which will print the file size of an existing file. So go ahead and create a file or just copy and paste some files into a folder that you want to check the file size of, and then go ahead and develop the code. The second task in this challenge is to capture any errors should the file not exist, or perhaps you don't have permissions to access the file. So maybe be creative here. Maybe create a print output to display to the user that there has been an error. So go ahead and have a go at the challenge, and then when you're ready, let's go through some of the solutions. So let's go ahead and have a look at some of the solutions here. Right, so solution one, let's go ahead and import OS. So if you don't know what OS is, OS, or the OS module in Python, provides functionalities for us to manage files and directories. We are going to need a file, in actual fact, to measure the size of. So let's go ahead and create a new file here, just called example. .text, and let's just go ahead and just add some text. Okay, right, so now we have a text file, and now this text file is in the same directory, and that's important when you go ahead and try and search for that file. So let's go ahead now and set the path. So we'll set a path variable. Let's call this example. So the file is in the same directory, so we're just going to name the file. Of course, if it was in a different directory, we'd need to find the path or define the path to the file. So next up, let's go ahead and use size, or create a size variable. So we're going to take the OS, and then we're going to access path dot, and then utilize the function get size. Okay, so that's expecting a path. So we need to pass in the path, which we've already defined here. So it's just example.txt because the example text is in the same directory. Now let's go ahead and print this. So let's say size in bytes. So the get size function is going to produce this size, or output the size in bytes. So size in bytes, and then let's get the size. So let's go ahead and see that in the terminal. So let's run Python and then the file. And there we go. So the size in bytes is 20 bytes. So if we go ahead and open our folder, we can see that in actual fact, the operating system here is telling me that this file example.txt is 20 bytes. So let's take a look at how we might be able to capture some errors here. So first of all, let's go ahead and actually create an error. So I rename the file. Obviously that file does not exist anymore. We go ahead and we can see here that we've generated this error, file not found, error two, no such file or directory. So we can capture this error here through the OS error. So let's go ahead and just adapt this code slightly. So let's say try. So we're going to try and, first of all, get the size of the file if it exists. Now, of course, if the file doesn't exist, then we want to perform some sort of action. So let's go ahead and kind of capture the error. If there is an error, let's go ahead and just print something. So we're just going to print something simple here. Let's just say file error. So the reasons why you might create an error here, one, because the file doesn't exist, or two, like I said in the preview, this file might be inaccessible to the particular user that's running this file, or sorry, running this program. So a permissions problem. Let's go ahead and exit the program, and then, or else, let's go ahead and print. So we already have the print in actual fact, so let's use the print, the previous print, so we can see the whole code, and there we go. So let's go ahead now and try this, and you can now see that it says name sys is not defined. So we also have to import sys. So let's bring that in too, and let's try again. And this time you can see that we've outputted the error. Or should I say, you can see that we've captured the error, and then we've gone ahead and printed out our error text. So notice here, I've also used sysexit. So what is that? Well, let's go ahead and take it out and run the code. You can see that this time we still have an error. It says name size is not defined. Because what's happening here is that, yes, we've seen the error and we're printing out file error, I believe, a little bit up, further up here, but the code is still running. So the program still continues. And then of course we try to print out the size, and obviously the size doesn't exist because the file doesn't exist. So you can see here that sysexit allows us to exit the program, stop running the program. So as I alluded to, getSize is an actual function. So there's some code behind this, and we can have a look at the source code to see what's happening. If you head over to the CPython libgenericpath.py in the GitHub repository here, this is the source code that's utilized to essentially compile your Python code. So let's go in here, and we can actually search for the function get size, and you can see here what's being returned, or what's being utilized, is osstat. And then we're parsing the file name, that's what we're parsing into the function, or our function. And then you can see here we're utilizing .stsize. So let's go ahead and have a look and drill down to osstat. So now we can go ahead and navigate to the Python documentation, have a look at stat here, and you can see that the stat module defines constants and functions for interpreting the results of osstat. So there's a whole load of different tools here that we can utilize, and one of them just happens to be finding the file size. So we saw from the previous source code, it utilized stsize, and that here, if you read, it's the size in bytes of a plain file. So that's what's going to be returned. So in actual fact, instead of utilizing the getSize function, we can go ahead and just use stsize from stat. So let's go ahead and change this slightly. So let's say os, then stat, and then let's go ahead and input path. And then this time, let's go for stsize. So let's go ahead and just change the name of the file back to the file. And now let's go ahead and run the code. And you can now see it's returning the size in bytes again. If you are working with files, it's well worth reading through this documentation page. For example, here you can see that stat can be utilized to access a number of different properties of a file. For example, time of last access, time of last modification. So there we have another completed challenge. I hope that was useful, and I hope to see you in the next challenge.